Hello, and thank you for watching this regional forecast for the Northeast. I'm Andrew Pritchard, meteorologist with Nutrien Ag Solutions. Well, as one storm system departs, another one arrives, bringing major winter impacts here to parts of the upper Midwest, the Great Lakes, and the central Corn Belt over the weekend. This will begin to spread into the Northeast region over the last half of the weekend as well. As we take a look at things, a big area of red shading, blizzard warnings in the northern plains, winter storm warnings in the upper Midwest, a large area of winter weather advisories surrounding that. Not much in the way of advisories just yet across the Northeast region, but that may change as we head through the next 24 hours or so and the impacts are sorted out. This is an experimental product from the National Weather Service, our Winter Storm Severity Index. They take a look at the total snow, freezing rain, ice accumulation, winds, temperatures, and attempt then to kind of quantify the impacts here to civilization. And across the Northeast region, we see a smattering of this yellow and orange color shading here, and a little, if you kind of squint your eyes here, parts of northern New York where we could see some lake effect snow bumps it into the major impacts here. We'll talk about those impacts here in just a moment, but starting with this look at the satellite picture, and again, the first storm system pulling away that brought a corridor of snow to northern portions of the Northeast region. You can see the flow off of the coast there, and then our next area of low pressure developing across the central part of the country. So you look at the radar, we can see precipitation spreading from the southern plains into the central plains and the Midwest today, continuing to lift off to the north and to the east. Temperatures as we get the day started, sub-zero across the northern portion of the Northeast region, trending down to near freezing as you head off to the south. Day-by-day impacts with this, high pressure coming in on the backside of the departing storm system, so we're quiet. Midday Friday, all the way into Saturday night. This is midnight on Saturday night. Precipitation still just to the west of the area here, but it does start to move into parts of Pennsylvania, into Maryland, as we get into the morning hours on Saturday. That snow beginning to fall and overspread the region, lifting north. Now, this storm system lifts to the north, and what that does is it draws warm air northward. So Pennsylvania, by the time we get to Saturday evening, transitioning to a wintry mix, before transitioning over to rain as we finish things up across southern portions of the area. Where it will stay primarily wintry precipitation is off to the north across parts of northern and central New York, Vermont, New Hampshire, Maine, Massachusetts, Connecticut, Rhode Island, keeping things primarily in the frozen precipitation department. As we get to sunrise on Sunday, the area of low pressure is maturing, beginning to occlude and pull off to the north into the east. Snow coming around on the backside, very cold air, very strong winds. It's going to be a blustery Sunday morning. Snow continuing on the backside here across parts of western northern New York, parts of western and northern Pennsylvania, and then into Vermont, New Hampshire, and Maine. As we get into Monday morning, the storm system has departed the area, but very strong northwest flow coming over the top of the Great Lakes here, keeping lake effect snow in the forecast across the west. So we'll look at the high resolution NAM model, the precipitation forecast. That will show us the timing on this storm system. Again, a Midwest and the Corn Belt storm system or a problem here Friday into Friday night. As we get into Saturday morning, seeing that snow spread into parts of Pennsylvania, western New York, transitioning over to a wintry mix. As we head into Saturday afternoon, that's when that snow starts lifting into the rest of the region, New York, Massachusetts, Connecticut, Rhode Island, starting to push into Vermont, New Hampshire, and Maine. As we head into Saturday evening, and then seeing that wintry mix continuing across southern portions of the region here. Strong winds come in on the backside, bringing in much colder temperatures. We'll look at the temperature forecast here through the weekend. As we get to, this would be 6 a.m. on Saturday. We'll freeze it right here. Starting to see warmer air being drawn northward in advance of the area of low pressure, and then you see the very sharp cold front right in this region with very strong northwest flow coming in on the backside. Take it further a little bit as we head into Saturday evening now. We're at 6 p.m. on Saturday evening. Same story, seeing some of that warm air lifted north in advance of the storm system. Precipitation kind of stunting the warm-up across this region as we have snow beginning to fall. And then as we head into, let's take this all the way into Sunday morning, 9 o'clock on Sunday morning, seeing that cold front clear the area. This is when very strong winds out of the northwest and out of the west will start bringing in much colder temperatures to the region. Total precipitation forecast over the next week. This is going to drop a corridor, again, of nearly an inch from parts of the Ozarks in through the central and eastern Corn Belt, with heaviest precipitation off to the west here as we talk about the northeast region. Parts of western Pennsylvania into northern New York could see anywhere from 3/4 of an inch to 1.5 inches of liquid precipitation. Elsewhere, looking at about 1/2 inch or less across this across the northeast region as this storm system kind of quickly makes its way through the area. As we look at total snow accumulation, this is through midday on Sunday, looking at the heaviest snow occurring across northern portions of the area. across the northern Pennsylvania, getting into New York, Vermont, New Hampshire, Maine, Massachusetts, could pick up anywhere from 4 to 10 inches of snow, heaviest in lake effect snow corridors, where we could see snow squalls continuing through the weekend, dumping considerably higher corridors of snow. As you head off to the south across central and southern Pennsylvania, where we transition, this is where we could end up with a slushy mess here. You see a couple of inches accumulation forecast here, but seeing temperatures warm into the event, transitioning over to a wintry mix, and then perhaps rain as you head off to the south. So it's possible that the snow that does accumulate early in this event does not stick around for long. Now, as we head through the next 5 days, we're going to bring some much colder air into the region, thanks, courtesy of the Canadian Prairie. You see it right here, warm air feeding into the region in advance of the storm system. But here's that corridor of very cold air that will be making its way off to the south and to the east as we head into the weekend. This is as we get into Sunday and then eventually Monday, seeing that cold air setting up coldest across the upper Midwest into the central Corn Belt. We don't really get the most extreme impacts of that cold air before we start to moderate and warm back up as we head into mid to late next week. So a cold push of air, but it doesn't have staying power at this point. It's going to be a brief intrusion of more seasonally appropriate temperatures. Your highs for the day on Friday, single digits in the north, near freezing as you head off to the south, teens in the north and near freezing in the south on Saturday. That cold front sweeps through on Sunday, temperatures falling for many across the region, and then as we get into Monday afternoon, warming back into the teens in the north to the mid-20s across Pennsylvania and New Jersey into Maryland. As we head into the weekend, our overnight lows sub-zero across the north Friday night into Saturday, warming in advance of the next storm system, so overnight lows considerably warmer on Saturday night into Sunday. It's as we get into Monday and then Tuesday morning, we'll see that cold air begin to take shape. As always, Eric Snodgrass will have an in-depth look at the next 1 to 2 weeks in our Monday morning ag forecast video, and then Tuesday morning, I'll be back to talk about the Northeast. Have a great day, a wonderful weekend, and do stay safe out there as we handle yet another winter storm in the Northeast.